Hello, my name's Netbox, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create a texture template for your 3D model or video game model. I'm going to quickly go over what a texture template is. It's basically a Photoshop file with multiple layers to enable the quick and efficient editing of textures. So as you can see here, there's a color layer, which you can edit directly onto, get creative. You're completely free to do whatever you want with patterns or be it brush. And then above that, we have the lighting textures of the model collapsed into an alpha layer. And this adds detail, and it also helps out users without post-processing settings. Exclusions, that's just one of the biggest helps of a template. It means all the bits that you don't usually want to edit are there, and it means a normal job that could take hours can be completed in a matter of minutes. Here I have an example of a community texture up against the original, and you can see there's been some opportunities for improvements and detail missed out on, you know, there's lights missing and stuff. And this is just to show that with a template, even a texture as simple as this can be greatly improved on. Here is a demonstration for reasons of collapsing your lighting layers onto your texture. You've got a finished template, and I'm going to quickly go over all the layers. So down at the bottom, you've got the original. This is the obviously the original texture, which you can use for reference. Above that, we've got the color, where you're going to be doing most of the editing. You can apply patterns, anything, and that'll be filtered. And then above that, you've got the yellow layer. This is similar to the color. You've got call signs, you've got the Bravo Hotel, we've got effects like these gunshots here. We've also got markings, anything, emblems, logos, we've got that eagle. Lots of things you can do here. You can also make a theme pattern or something like I've got here. I've got an unpainted panel there. Above that, we've got the filters, which I talked a bit about earlier. You can notice that they also help in the editing of this template. You know, you can see where the rivets are and what is what, basically. And above that, the only problem with the filters is they do alter the color through contrast and brightness, so I've got a corrective layer for that, which you can edit to suit your needs. The only thing you do have to do is make sure if a model has multiple textures that they're all set to the same correction. And above that's obviously exclusion, which includes wheels, you know, anything, lights, everything. The biggest convenience with a template is you can just take a photo, go into it, find the color you want, and then just bring that straight back to the template, and you're all done. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to create a template. I'm going to be using the SUV from Arma 3. I'm not going to complete this, but I'm going to give you an idea of what to do. To begin with, you want to open GIMP. Set your texture dimensions, mine at 2K, and then set the background to transparent. You want to collect your files. So here I've got the color map, ambient shadow, normal, and specular map. As you notice, the Arma 3 ones come in PAA, so you're going to want to use Texview to convert them
to TGA
or PNG. PNG supports transparency. Once you've collected them, you're going to open them up in GIMP one by one. I'm starting with the ambient shadow map. And you're going to go color, desaturate. Come back to the color menu and go color to alpha. This is a really great tool, which I've only found in GIMP. You then want to export as a Photoshop file, or just continue in GIMP if you intend to use GIMP. I use Photoshop because I find it better for the bits later on. I make a folder, a file called transfer, which I'll use for all of them. I then open that in Photoshop, rename it, and then duplicate it to the template, which you can find in the description. You then add it to the filter group, to just to keep it tidy. As you can see, things are already coming together. And now I'm going to repeat all those steps for the normal and specular map. Okay, so on the left is what you should have by now. The only problem is the wheels and other details like underneath the car, they're all white or grey or something. So there are several ways to fix this. One is to take the original and use that, or you can recreate those assets if you want. Okay, so there's a couple of ways to get the exclusions from the original. You obviously want to take a copy of the original and put it in the exclusions folder. Now, the way I'm going to show you now is going to be using any selection tool you want to use and select parts of the model which you want the template to represent. So here I'm selecting the car body and just clicking delete. So the template shows through. And I'm not going to complete it, I'm just going to give you an idea, but this is what a finished one would look like. The whole body and every bit that you want to be blue or whatever, it's blue. The alternative is to copy out the car wheels and starch into a separate layer. It's completely up to you which one you do. It's often dependent on the texture itself. Okay, the third method is basically to have a source, you know, uncollapsed version of the details. This solves a big problem, is when you're cutting up the texturing into exclusions, you're going to lose small details as shown there, which you sometimes have to remake. By now, you've got a basic enough texture, but there's lots of room for improvement. I'm just going to be showing you some basic improvements to give you an idea of what you want to be doing. There's no means the best way to do it. There are much better resources out there for it. Okay. So I'm starting to try and make a rally car. I've got some basic shapes here. Notice that nothing's collapsed, not rastertized or anything, so anything can be changed. The idea of shapes is most relevant in aircraft. As you can see, they've got straight lines running down them, and this can be hard to replicate in a model because the shape goes across multiple elements and the layout of the texture doesn't always suit this kind of texturing. Other improvements can come in the form of effects, dust, wear, anything. You can find lots of this kind of stuff on the internet. I've just taken a photo from Google Images. You can also do gunshots like I'd done earlier with the Chinook. And you can create patterns to use with the pattern stamp if you wish. Now I'm going to go on to demonstrating a few of these. One of the best ways to do this and to keep it random is to use a custom brush, massively overscaled. You can find these all over the internet. So in this case, I'm just going to be taking the color I picked out of that image, making a new layer, obviously. Selecting the area I'm going to be editing, because you don't want to have rust all over the car, so I'm going for the wheel rim here. And then I'm just going to click around to get the effect I want. I mean, it's perfectly okay to experiment here. You might want to make multiple rust layers with different intensity. The idea, you know, the whole idea of a template is to create complete modularity so people can quickly choose what they want, or yourself can choose what they want. For some vehicles, you may want, you know, a heavily dusted version of it, and a lightly or clean version of it. It's really key to add noise, rust and stuff, because it's very easy, especially in Arma 3, to make your models look too clean. And that's the problem with lots of community textures out there. Okay, so now I'm doing exactly the same, but I'm applying dirt. Okay, and now I'm just going to quickly demonstrate the pattern using the pattern stamp. It's exactly the same. except I'm using a pattern and you get a nice, a bit of a better effect, but it's completely up to you. Now to test the texture, I'm going to bring it into Arma 3. I mean, it's okay, but there are lots of rooms for improvement. You can even see from this photo that it is much too clean. There needs to be a lot more time spent on adding dust, dirt, and rust to it. Like I said earlier, the texture layer isn't always going to suit your needs, and you can see the shape here is slightly off when it goes from the rear car door to the rest of the body. And this is because the texture layout comes from one element to the other. This can be fixed manually. It's a bit of hard work, but it's the only way to do it. There's also some other minor things to fix. I mean, you know, there's lots of work to do here. A well-made template is an infinitely useful resource. I'd like to thank you for watching. I'm Nevbox. Happy texturing.